Dressing is this, chemoport is this, feeding is this, nasal tube is this, tracheostomy is this. We have a protocol I made, I just gave them the protocol. We documented everything, and then when they go home, they find that the wound is not healthy, there is a discharge, the red signal is immediately alerted. Through video call, WhatsApp, pictures come promptly to me, to my duty mobile, our doctors, we address it immediately, we know readmission. So we did this, and if there is anything emergency, they have a prompt hospital stay. So we used in surgical onco, medical onco, nursing care, home equipment. Believe me, in oncology, it is tremendous. Giving a lymphopress exercise or just giving a device, it's a huge thing. Just giving a walking chair, a clutches. I remember a patient, they say, they're just not ready to go home. I'm wondering why you are fine eating everything. I just couldn't break the news. 10,000 every day they're paying, and because they are there, you have to go and see medically. The moment I see, 1,000 rupees my consultation. And they are high diabetic, my physiologist, 1,000 rupees. I just wondering. Then finally I asked them, what is it? They told that we don't have a Western toilet. So we just have an Indian toilet, and you know, you can't sit. And there is a device where it's like a chair, you make a hole and they make it sit. They just told, if you had told, I would have just gone 60,000 before the bill was less. Small devices, how it can change. Believe me that, oh, that is also, so we can't break the toilet. Son is thinking, who is going to break toilet? Where am I going to keep? No relative is going to keep. So there is a chair, just put it on Indian toilet, become Western toilets. One device can change whole thing, and the ecosystem can change there. And in medical oncology, my colleagues use for Hickman, PCC, sample collection, removal. Imagine, you know that there is a chemo. They have to come for a CBC, they collect it, next day they show, and yeah, it is fine, then your chemo is posted, then daycare booked. Now imagine somebody comes home, takes from the chemo board, CBC done, it comes to doctor, and they just try to come for an admission. Three visits, half a day, everything is gone. Now this is how we have totally done there to do that. Colostomy bags, tracheostomy, drain care, everything changed for us. This is the algorithm, we actually put it up in home care in Manipal Hospital with Portia. Every patient we have made a protocols. The nurse or the trained person goes home, they follow the protocol, they see that no complication, they document it, it comes to me in an email. So I just know it is fine, I pass it on to my doctors. If there is any complication or problem, they will just see either by WhatsApp a picture, it's a minor thing, I just say, okay, just send a swab, start this antibiotic 2 days back intensive, or it needs transfer. So this is a triage I follow, and I have tremendous confidence on this. Actually, I have to speak to my patients who trust, see, it's easy for me, it's not my life, my surgery. Always a patient believes what you hear from another patient. I say, I'll do this surgery, HIPEC. At the end of it, they say, fine, doctor, everybody say you're a good surgeon. Can I meet another patient who has done like that? Doctor is no time. If another patient says, all what doctor is fine, but believe me, after 1 month only, you can go and work. You can never work. 10 days will be pain. That's a golden word. So it's like, patient who will say what happened there. So this is actually a win-win situation. For a patient, no stress of traveling, waiting. Low infection rate, they're out of hospital. Direct or indirect cost is not there. Remember, direct cost is very minimal. Healthcare is the cheapest. Doctor is the easiest, cheapest person available in India. All other systems surrounding them is very expensive. You know that. Reduce stress for the patient. Doctors, continuous connectivity is there. Patient is outside, but I keep knowing what's happening. I just know, okay, this is the calcium today, so there is no hypercalcemia. I'm just getting real time. Efficient time use. My doctor, who is a 5 year post MS doing DMBC, is not sitting doing a small dressing which a trained just medical healthcare can do. He's busy with me with an OT or writing a paper or doing some other surgeries, and you can cater more patients now. Otherwise you have a outpatient of 10, 20 are just like, just to know I'm fine. Somebody else can do that. So I can use my time efficiently. Now imagine in the hospital, one bed, patient goes home rightly, it is available for the next, reduce load in the OR, high revenue per bed, and you have a differential tool. You know, this is something very, very important. These are all my patients and my home care. This is the bag, and the staff goes there and the changes there. These are all our patients. Feeding, just this tube going into the tummy is a scary thing. You just show the staff how they do 2 to 3 days, then they say, oh, this is all we have to do. They observe in the home 2 times, 3 times, and then the people who speak in front of doctor, big words, are never there to take care. The person who are pushed back are the one who is going to take care. When you go to home, you really know who is the one and teach them. And believe me, they'll not come back. There's no readmission, no complaints. Otherwise, this son is there once in a week. He sees, oh, this all is happening. They'll make a call. They'll trouble you. They're not the user people. So, you know, feeding tubes which are used in our patient, this is a chemo port. So all they need to do is just, you know, take the blood or give antibiotic through my chemo port. And I know that my staff is the one who is trained. They'll not spoil my chemo port. Tracheostomy, suctioning. So just for suctioning, they're to stay. And believe me, most of these patients who end up is either a polytrauma patients you have, or you have a stroke patient. Already by the time they become belly shot up, every day you stay 10-20,000 rupees, and for a simple suctioning, life would be revolutionized if a staff can go home for 500, you have a small portable vacuum suction with a leg pump, and you can just do that, it would just do great for all these patients. So we analyzed with our home care in Manipal what difference it made. This is our personal data. You can see that I roughly put up the complex oncology surgery I do in a patient, a bill where it would sit roughly about 2 lakh rupees with all the things sitting in a complex major resection, everything together. The moment the home care came, patient is sent home early, so they save roughly about 40,000 because they're not paying. And then instead of this, they paid. This is the average major surgical oncology cases I took a data. Now, second thing is when they come back. So when they come back to see you, actually, is 600 rupees what you make pay you as a consultation. But transport miscellaneous day cost is huge. When you see 500, 300, 200, 1,000 to 2,000 is what they spend to just consult a super specialist in a corporate hospital. But here comes the home care. See, everything goes down. So miscellaneous charges, including parking, food, home care can save all of them, daycare, bag change, stoma care, flushing, everything is done. So this I just observed, what is the change that we actually had? More important is I really wanted to see how many patients we could serve on that given bed. You can see that if I can do about 100 on the same bed because I kept them for a long time, with home care, early discharge, new patient getting in, calculation for a 30 day we made, length of hospital stay came from 7 to 3 and remaining 4 days is in home, the hospital could double on the same thing. You know, if I'm treating 100 patients in the same daycare or the OR surgical oncology, my bed strength, I could go to 200 and I can treat more patients who really need. These are our own personal data. I hope I'll publish it soon now that I've systematically done it. What is the impact we had? We broke it down with help of my home care team. About 130 cases of surgical onco, 2 per day home care we analyzed, 250 from medical, per patient 600 rupees they saved, total saving was 23 lakh. Average length of stay patient went home, reduction in length of stay for even 2.5 days saved about 11,000 rupees. In our 130, we saved about 15 lakh rupees. Bed was freed. What could have been used for 100 days became 300. So you can see the revenue just in a small pilot study we did in my patients. What is the impact that we had on that? This is something I really want to share. I must the name. Top VIP of India, very intelligent guy, had a TCC bladder cell CA. Very superficial. Or he had a TURBT done in an outside hospital in Bangalore. Very good doctor, very good thing. Rightfully, they told that you need intravesical BCG. He required every week, admit, put the catheter, put the BCG, monitor, change, go. He told that all my life I work for Government of India, all my family, children are top. He just told that 6 weeks, every week, nobody is there with me. I just cannot come. He refused to take the treatment where it could be cured, bladder could be done. He went to various hospitals everywhere. Everybody rightfully advised. Then he just sat in home. And he's such a top guy. There was another, award-winning doctor who told, you're such a friend, why you can't say? He told that, I know this is a treatment. He just told, I just can't. I never could believe 6 visits in 6 months and 6 weeks interval was not possible for a guy who has worked for Government of India in top place. Then they just told, no, Somshekhar, you just go. They told, you'll not only treat, you'll put a passion. He don't know. I know that everybody, he will also say, intravesical BCG is required. I cannot come and take in bladder and go. He just told, it's not possible because nobody is there and my daughter is working for Government of India. She's a top bureaucrat. I can't tell her to come. I have troubled everybody in life. I'm not going to do it. He just came. I just told, what is your concern? Everybody thought he was refusing for intravesical BCG. That is what he gave an impression. I just asked him, what is that fear you have? He told, no, I don't want. I'm fine. God is fate. I've lived my life. Remote, it comes back. I just told, leave all that. Cut the crap. Come to bottom line. I asked him very hardly. He told that, are you afraid of BCG? I told, no. There's no complication. Are you afraid? No. Then he told me this. I told that, if you don't have to come and see me for 6 months, if I can arrange this, we have a protocol of BCG, all you need to do is put an infant, when you put that, I told her, I'll just send my trained personnel home. He just shocked, is it possible? I told her, you just see how it happens. I sent him, every week, 6 weeks, he took it, he completed the BCG therapy, without telling me, he wrote this note. He wrote a fantastic note, really tears comes. He wrote to the person who did that, he wrote to my director about it. I could never see such an impact could really happen. I could really never ever think of it. This is another one of my patients who is from US. I did a robotic, I did a temporary stoma. Very rich family, wife literally abandoned role. I will not touch it. His wife in front of patient, everybody is very happy, young guy. After that, wife and then the brothers in very top business people. Doctor, you keep in the home. I just, who you want to touch? He said, wife told that, I know all that is old, Sati Savitri is all gone. I will cook, I will take care of everything. I can't change. We put the home care. This guy really wrote this letter with tears. You know, I just can't even tell you that I really realized the last part, who really helps. And they're all my patient. I can't even put so much of testimonials. It was really like awesome what has happened to my patient. And I love to hear from them, you know. So this is what a health home care would do. I'll not trouble you. You can read it, all of your doctors.